Now, see our next topic, nuclear fusion. Nuclear fusion is a reaction in which two or more nuclei are combined to form one or more different atomic nuclear and subatomic particles. It is a nuclear process where energy is produced by massing together light atoms. It is the opposite reaction of fission. That means it is quite opposite to fission. That means nuclear fission. In nuclear fission, one atom can be split into two atoms. But here, two atoms combine together with light atoms. So that's why this is quite opposite to nuclear fission. See the reaction, H12 plus H12 gives less 2, helium-23 plus 1 neutron and it gives 3.27 mega electron volt. That means this process in which two lighter nuclei like hydrogen is split into helium nuclei. Here in this, small mass losses is converted into energy. In this process we can get huge amount of energy. But here we have one problem, that is when the hydrogen are together, that means are getting together, then the large amount of electrostatic repulsion between to gets very high temperatures. That means when two hydrogens are combined together, it get a large amount of electrostatic repulsion between this two hydrogen atoms. The temperature is at approximately 10 to the power of 6 kelvins. The temperature could not be achieved is controller man on the earth. Then it is equal to sun energy. So here the sun generates its energy from the nuclear fusion. That means the lighter nuclei is bombarded with helium, then whose amount of energy is liberated. In this process the sun receives the energy from that process, then the sun generates its energy from the nuclear fusion. This is called one of the nuclear energy by the nuclear fusion process. So here the two protons within the sun fuse, most of the time the pair breaks apart again. But sometimes one of the protons transforms in a neutron via the weak nuclear force. That means a third proton collides with the formed deuterium. Two helium 3 nuclei collide, create a helium 4 nucleus plus 2 extra neutrons. That means it sometimes will be happening there. So what will happen in a nuclear fusion reaction? That means in nuclear fusion we can get a energy when two atoms join together to form one. In a fusion reactor, hydrogen atoms come together to form helium atoms, neutrons and waste amount of energy. It is the same type of reaction that powers hydrogen bombs and the sun. So there are the several types of fusion reactions. So in fusion, a chemical reaction should be there, as well as your fission are actually not chemical reactions. They are nuclear reactions. The basis of chemical reaction is the exchange of electrons, and the amount of energy generated is relatively small. So the nuclear fission all are based on simple chemical reactions. Now fusion, what will happen here? In fusion process require fuel and confined environment with sufficient temperature, pressure and confinement time to create a plasma. It means, however, the necessary combination of temperature, pressure and duration has proven to be a difficult to produce in a practical and economical manner. It requires a very high temperature. The temperature gives the hydrogen atoms enough energy to overcome the electrical repulsion between the protons. So, the fusion requires temperatures about 100 million kelvins. So, if the fusion is very hard, why it is hard? In the air, it is very difficult to start nuclear fusion reactions that release more energy than in need to start the reaction. The reason is the fusion reactions only happen at high temperature, pressure, like in the sun, because both nuclei have a positive charge. That's why the positive ripples to each other. And it is also a radioactive element. So finally, in nuclear energy, by these two processes, that means nuclear fission process and nuclear fusion process. So we can get the, from nuclear fusion, we can get the electricity from the sun. In nuclear fission, we can get electricity from the nuclear reactor. Now see the differences between fusion and fusion. Let's see the first point. In fission, it is defined as division of single atom to multiple atoms of small size. That means uranium is split into barium and krypton. In fusion, here it is a joining of two or more small atoms to form a large atom. That means two hydrogen can be form a helium. And second one, it requires a less energy to divide atoms into two or more. In fusion, a massive amount of energy is required to combine small atoms to form a large atom. And see the third one. The energy produced in nuclear power plants uses this fusion technology. In experimental in power plants uses this fusion technology. And in fission, never occurs in nature in normal cases. But it takes place stars and sun that natural forces in nuclear fusion. And the ideal conditions of the nuclear fission is necessity to have a critical mass of substance and neutrons with high speed. But it has high density and high temperature atmosphere are the requirements for nuclear fusion. And uranium is the primary fuel in nuclear power plant. And hydrogen and isotopes are used as fuel in experimental plants in nuclear fusion. And finally, in fission, it produces highly radioactive substances. And in fusion, very few radioactive chemicals come out of the reaction. These are the main differences between fission and fusion reaction. So, in nuclear energy, generation is the storage and disposal of spent or used fuels, that is, the uranium still decaying in harmless subatomic particles, improper nuclear waste storage and disposal result in environmental contamination. Further, there is a risk of accidental leakage of nuclear radiation. The high cost of installation of nuclear power plant, high risk environmental contamination and intimidated availability of uranium makes large scale uses of nuclear energy prohibitive. Now, nuclear energy was first used for the destructive purposes before nuclear power stations were designed. The fundamental physics of the fission chain reaction in a nuclear weapon is a small similar to a physics of controlled nuclear reactor. But the two types of devices are engaged quite differently. In nuclear fission, by nuclear fusion, the hydrogen bomb is based on the thermonuclear fusion reaction. A nuclear bomb based on the fission of uranium or plutonium is placed at the core of hydrogen bomb. The nuclear bomb is embedded in a substance which contains deuterium and lithium when the nuclear bomb is detonated, the temperature of the substance is raised to 10 to the power of 7 K kelvins in a few microseconds. The high temperature generates sufficient energy for the light nuclei to fuse, and a devastating amount of energy is released. See, this is the most probability of nuclear energy. Thank you. See you for the next class.